next movement, which is commonly referred to the opening of the form, where the hands rise and fall, is used to bring in a force that starts off as a horizontal line of energy, and we turn it into a vertical, so we pull it straight down. So what happens is, just to show you from a totally different stance, we pull the force in, we sink with correct postural alignment, come underneath like this, and then let the force out. The hands only go because you're following your opponent away. Well, essentially what you're doing is getting underneath them with your connection to the ground and breaking their connection to the ground. So it sounds very simple from now, but it's a feeling. It's nothing you can think about and learn or read in a book. It's a feeling. So you must feel this with your partner and trainer. So let's look at it from a diagonal here. We start off, we do our opening, we're here, one, two, three. Now, we bring our hands out to meet the force. We don't let it come in here. We never run away from it and we never resist. So don't insist and don't resist. So when it comes, don't bridge up and let it push out straight away and don't run away from it. What you want to do is be already open as a spring within all the ligaments and limbs within your body, all the joints here. They're open, they relax so they can fold. Now see, as my hands come in, I'm sinking. You see that? With my knees, I'm sinking. My knees are sinking directly over the top of my feet, so it's all parallel, so I'm connected to the ground. The butt tucks in. Okay, when the butt tucks in, that's when I begin to push out. But I don't push with force. I've come underneath my opponent, so I stick to them. And when we practice this with two people, we only aim at the beginning to see their feet rise. So again, from the front, sink. Sink into your right leg, but don't be like this, remember. So sink, still posturally aligned, step out where it's comfortable, come over. Come back into the right leg. Here, sink, the hands raise, relax, feel all the connective parts of your body align with relaxation. When the force comes in, you sink, you bring the hands in. You tuck your buttocks in, you let the force out. Again, from this side. Let's see it from this angle, slightly diagonal. Force comes in on a horizontal plane of energy. I sink to bring it down. I tuck underneath my opponent's connection to the ground. I'm connected to their spine and their center of gravity with my stick. So I've got to put my awareness into their center. I come underneath and then I follow them out. That's the principle. Again, from this side. I meet the force. I bring the force in. There's a lag here. See, this drags in. Here, this drags in. My hips keep going. I sink underneath as this keeps going and brings them out further, overextends them. I come underneath and I bounce out. So the further I can over withdraw my opponent or my partner, the bigger the issue becomes. So if I'm here and I've brought them in and my hips are already there, they're locked, but I'm still bringing them in, as soon as I rebound with that connection through my hands, I can bounce them off.